Welcome to Real Quick Radio, where we give you a verbal image of life, and we are everyday people. Like to welcome you all to the show. As you all know that Verbal Quick Radio, we don't do what everybody else do because we're not everybody else. With that being said, we're going to pause for a minute and come back and hit you with some reality.
You pick a piece of paper from that woman regarding something that was owed by Duncantel. Where is it? What date was it?
All from yesterday. Jerome took it upstairs. I have to call him and pick it up when I switched out the picture. I'll call him.
I don't want you to do a goddamn thing. I want you to have a fucking brain. I want you to have read it. I want you to say Congresswoman, it was such and such date. That's what I want. That's the kind of staff that I want to have. So some stupid other motherfucker did it, and I don't have the information. Nobody's sent me the information. I need to ensure my schedule, and you know, if boo-boo did it, shit-ass did it, fuckface did it, and nobody knows a goddamn thing in my office. Okay, nothing. I gave it to you. Your job was to get it on the calendar, imprint it in your brain, or send me the information back saying, Congresswoman, I made sure that the Ovid Duncantel event that you gave me for so-and-so date at 7 is on the fucking calendar. Not to, oh, Jerome has it. Okay? So when I called Jerome, he told me sitting up there like a fat-ass, stupid idiot, talking about what the fuck he doesn't know. Okay? Both of y'all are fuck-ups, a fucking F. It's the worst shit that I could ever have put together. Two goddamn big-ass children. Fucking idiots. Serve no goddamn purpose. Ain't managing nobody. Nobody's respecting them. Nobody gives a shit about what you're doing. And you ain't doing shit. And this is an example of it. I gave it to you wrong. This is not child's work. Okay?
Yeah, it's absolute.
Now, nobody gives a shit about what you're doing because what you're doing ain't about shit. She'd have let them have it, right? But that's not what this show is about, though, really. Not what this show is about, because the Congresswoman gave us a great teaching moment to delve deeper into her comments, right? And why she felt comfortable in cussing these two black men out, right? And I'm just assuming they're black men. I'm going off the name Jerome, but maybe there are some white Jeromes, and I'm pretty sure it is, but more than likely they are black males, right? In my honest opinion, this stems from slavery, right? See, that's how the slave master talked to his slaves. And we learned how to be Americans from the slave master, right? But they all were the wrong example. All that beat your kids and so, they came from out of slavery. Now, the problem is, why do people defend that type of verbal abuse, right? Because when I looked at the comments of people who heard her remarks, some of the comments was, well, if they screwing up, she's supposed to get on them. You know? Yeah, when someone messes up and they're tired, that's how you talk to them. Some said, well, she didn't do anything wrong. In my humble opinion, that's only because we as a people, we're so used to disrespecting and talking to each other without respect, care, or love to where it's normal. Right? That's normal speech in the black community. You hear mothers talk to their children at a young age. Get your ass over here. Get your stupid ass, dumb motherfucker. This, I mean, all kind of shit, bro. you hear it. It's prevalent. It's, and people walk by and don't say nothing because they get it at their house too. Same thing. But we have to understand, is it too far? I guess is what I'm saying. Is that type of speech too far, and should it be normal? Or do they say, well, you have to have tough skin. If you complain about speech like that, you weak, you need tough skin. Right. Or do you say, hey, you don't speak to human beings that way. Don't you want respect? Would you like it if you were spoken to that way? Right. Would you like for your subordinates to speak to you in the manner in which she spoke to her subordinates? Or is that just the way of life? If they can't take it, go get another job. Right? But it's deeper than that when it comes to the black community, because that's the language that we grew up hearing across the board. And does it kill self-esteem, and does it demean an individual, especially children? We all know we done had parents, grandparents, aunts, uncles, neighbors talk to children real bad, cussing them out like sailors. And the child has to take it. But the child grows up thinking that that's normal. That's what they respond to. And if you're not speaking in that manner, something is wrong with you. Right. Or you're not taken serious. Right. That's how the jailers talk to them when they get into the system. Right. It's normal, is what I'm saying. That type of speech, right, can no longer be normal within the black community, especially with dealing with our youth. Right? We gotta handle our youth as if they are valuable and they mean something, so they can go out and portray that and go after something. If you treat them like they're nothing, they're gonna go after nothing. Because they used to being talked to as if they were nothing. Right? So we got to straighten all that out. That's all. So Shelia, and all being said, Shelia gave us a good teaching moment. Right? With all of this. You know, so some good did come out of it, is what I'm saying. We have to realize who we are and what we stand for and what we don't stand for. Obviously, it's been going on, and it got to the point to where her subordinates, her staff, had to record to get her back. That was their only way of fighting back after they felt that they were being verbally abused and demeaned and killing their drive and self-esteem. So they like, okay, well, here, this is my fire back at you moment. Take this shot, Shelia, bam. And now you're hearing calls for Shelia to step out of the mayor's race in Houston, right? You're hearing more people calling for other candidates and write-in candidates. And, you know, hey, it is what it is, but this was a good teaching moment, right? Right? We as a people, do we deserve to be spoken to with respect by our elders and by members of our own race? Or do we give them a pass and we just suck it up and take it and say, hey, it's normal, you know, we've been talked to like this since birth. And that's it. And is that the culture, a part of the culture? And do we want that to be part of our culture if it is part of our culture? right? Or do we want our elders and parents and adults to speak to the youth and to the people with respect? Verpic Radio, we're out.